Hello there, and welcome to another wonderful episode of Eye on Port, a proud program that comes your way, kind courtesy of West Blue Consulting Limited, Ghana Oil Company Limited, GOIL, and Ghana Community Network Services, GCNET. The media partner for the program is the Business and Financial Times. So always grab your copy of the BNFT and read more about the maritime and port business. People, this week we are going to hear from Customs as far as the gentleman who reported that he imported a 40-footer container filled with energy drink into this country, about 3,360 cartons of energy drink into this country. He gave about 35,000 cedis to his clearing agent to help him clear the entire goods. And indeed, the clearing agent cleared the goods but sold it and never returned the money to the owner, the importer, nor the consignment. We'll be talking about that pretty shortly. In the meantime, this week, by popular request, we are bringing you the significance of ports within this country as well as across the globe. We brought you that particular story in the last episode, and out of popular request, we are bringing you that again.
Seaports play important roles in the development of countries across the globe. They provide services to many other industrial sectors and are important points of intermodal logistic chains of key importance for the sustainable growth of most countries. In this episode, we are narrowing our satellite on the port of Singapore, which played significant roles in the development of Singapore, helping the Republic become a first world economy in one generation. The maritime industry currently contributes about 7% to Singapore's GDP, or 10% of the services sector, which makes up three quarters of the Singaporean economy. Led by a visionary leader who became the first Prime Minister, Lee Kuan Yew, Singapore was able to harness immensely from its ports.
Singapore's only option was for its leaders to fight hard for its survival.
I have a few million people's lives to account for. And Singapore will survive.
Through larger cranes, deeper berths and longer key lengths, Port of Singapore is one of the few ports in the world that is able to handle mega ships. An important milestone in Singapore's maritime history was the birth of containerization. On June 23, 1972, the newly built Tanjung Pagar Container Port welcomed its very first container ship. It was also Southeast Asia's first container port then. 225 personnel were specially trained for this momentous occasion, some to operate the giant cranes and others to become all-purpose workers at the new container port. And there has been no turning back since then, as the port has grown from strength to strength. In 2000, there were a total of 15 shipping groups in Singapore. By 2014, that number grew to 130. In Ghana, though, the Temara and Takoradi ports play crucial roles in the country's economy. The ports handle almost 80% of Ghana's national exports and imports. Also, over 80% of revenue collected by the Ghana Revenue Authority comes from the port of Temara alone.
Temara port is one of the most important ports for the government and for the country at such. Because the customs division's revenue, the target for the revenue, you collect about 82% of that revenue only from the Temara port.
The President of the Republic of Ghana, President John Dramani Mahama, in a working visit to Temara port to commission some port projects, said the country would shut down completely if the ports are not functioning.
And so the efficiency of running the port is critical to the economy of the country.
The port of Temara is currently undergoing an expansion and investment in infrastructural upgrading as part of efforts aimed at expanding facilities of Temara port to meet rising cargo traffic by the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority. Similar expansion works have already begun in Takoradi port, preparing that port to become the oil and gas hub of the sub-region. Fortunately, Ghana's ports are on a greater path to lead in the sub-region thanks to good management.
Over the years, and grown from 7% and moved it is a safe institution that is capable of running these forms efficiently to contribute to Ghana's economy.
This has led to the Port of Tema being ranked the best in the sub-region.
The Port of Tema are the biggest rich.
And the Port Authority winning a number of accolades across the globe.
Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority.
But in order for the ports of Ghana to drive the wheels of the nation's economy to the level of that of Singapore and others, a lot more attention needs to be paid to ensuring efficiency in the clearance trade, as well as improving infrastructures like the rail system and many more.
Well, I hope that you've been able to learn how important the ports of Ghana is to the economy of this country. And the president himself said it, that if the ports that you see behind me shut down, you can count on it, the entire country will be shut down. Iron Port got a request from a gentleman who said he imported a 40-footer filled with energy drink into this country, and the entire consignment was sold by his clearing agent, and he can't find that clearing agent. Take a listen to his request first.
Yeah, what happened is clearing agent got to a point and he called me informing me that there is an allegation that has cropped up at the GSL.
What is GSL?
Gateway Services. Yeah. With one guy bringing some policeman from Medina with his friends and a whole hullabaloo. And at the end of the day, the GSL decided to undervalue. They declared the goods were undervalued. So we cannot take our container back. So, in fact, when he told me this, it was
like Gateway Services Limited said you can't take your container out of the port.
Out of the port. Because the goods were declared undervalued. And the BL that I gave and the invoice that I gave declared the quantities of the goods. So I was even baffling that news came up.
An importer of a 40-footer container filled with 3,360 cartons of energy drink is accusing his agent of allegedly clearing the container on his blind side with his money and selling the items.
This story that he was saying the goods has been seized, because I am thinking that if the goods has been seized, there should be a letter attached to it that you did blah 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 blah. There wasn't any letter.
Speaking in an interview with Iron Port, George Asante, accompanied by his friend, said the agent absconded with an import duty of 32,319 Ghana cedis after he had requested for an additional 43,000 Ghana cedis as duties.
In fact, raising that amount was difficult. And what we did was, somebody also hinted us that it doesn't work that way, so we should watch our agent. So one day, we spoke to a different agent, and the agent said, no, we should capture some information from the document, the bill. And we did exactly, and showed the agent. So the agent did a follow-up into the system, and he said, oh, George, you're supposed to pay 22,000. So we confronted the agent. We
raised it. You're supposed to pay 22,000.
Instead of...
In addition to the
32,000.
Not 40.
Not the 40-something plus 50% penalty.
According to him, after paying the duties, the agent approached him that the 40-footer loaded with 3,360 cartons of energy drink cannot be found because a third party had cleared it from the port.
He was telling me that a friend of his who worked in the system, that's what he said, in the system has informed him that somebody has cleared the goods from the system. Then I said, how can
my container
from the system? Then I said, how can this be possible? Because you have my document. And I have given you money, so how can somebody create the goods of the system without your knowledge? And saying that is the situation. So I got down and said, okay, if that is the situation, then go to the police station, report.
He said he reported the issue to the police, which led to the subsequent arrest of the agent, who confessed to the police that he personally cleared the items but has sold them.
They brought him to the Tema, see, at the headquarters for interrogation, and he made mention some people that. And later he said it's some guys came with some documents, some lot of unnecessary information. So the crime officer even asked him, So with that document, did you call the one who contracted you to do the vaccine?
According to him, what he found interesting was the fact that the agent issued him a customs receipt of 15,000 Ghana cedis out of a banker's draft of 17,000 Ghana cedis he gave him to pay the customs duties.
Interesting thing about the duty we gave him, a banker's draft,
yes,
a car bank draft, which was amount into 16,949.91. He managed to pay less than this amount.
So this makes me believe that whatever story that he was telling us is a cock and bull story, because how he was able to do this, that means the information that he was giving us was like he wanted to get more money from us.
He said he has learned his lesson the hard way and would therefore endeavor to approach the Port Authority and Customs anytime he requires answers to issues bothering him.
Well, so upon hearing that, I was very, very shocked that a clearing agent who has been mandated or assigned by an importer could do that. I was so shocked. So we decided to approach Customs to find out whether they hear some of these cases at all and what is the way forward for this particular importer. Take a listen to what they had to tell us.
This importer who says he imported a 40-footer container filled with energy drink.
Right.
And when these items arrived in Ghana, he gave every document to the clearing agent. He gave him additional money of about 35,000 Ghana cedis to clear.
Yeah.
The clearing agent has cleared these goods.
Yeah.
And has sold it to somebody else without returning neither the goods nor the cash back to the importer.
Mm-hmm.
Now the importer is stranded. He's been harassed by his sources and all of that. How often do you hear issues like this, and what should people know about it?
See, this thing happens very regularly, you know.
I see. It happens?
Yes, oftentimes we hear people.
I was shocked, yes, when I heard it. I didn't know it does happen regularly.
Yes, it does. You know, really what, you know, importers have to do is that when you want to import your items, you have to go to an accredited agent. An agent who has an office that can easily be identified, you know. You even have to check the track record of the agency before engaging in them. Oftentimes, they meet with people just an actress who don't have any, you know, known offices. The risk is that, in fact, what actually tempts them those point to go in for this agents is that their charges are very low. Very low charges, as opposed to those who have got their recognized offices.
The recognized and registered offices.
So they are, you know, tempted to go in for their services. At the end of the day, something else happens.
So in this case, he's lost it.
He's lost it all. Because one,
unless he manages to get a clearing agent that then take it.
Yes. Oftentimes, they even don't know them by their full names. They don't know by names like Joe. You know, some first names and just that. Even their telephone numbers, they really do not have. You know. So when these things happen, then
even cell phone numbers, they can throw them away and buy new ones.
Yes, they may even decide to use a new phone for that transaction. After that, he throws that number away.
But why do we allow such people who parade around as agents to be around to be deceiving importers like this?
You see, the idea is that our law says that agents are not supposed to allow people who do not work with them to come and use their offices to clear goods for other people. But
so you must always go to the office if you're an importer.
Go to an office. Yes. Know the big man who is there. That's why an agency that's well organized. You know, when you get to an office, the office environment itself tells you volumes about the nature of business that office is doing.
Yeah.
If you get to an office that is well organized, it is clear for you to see.
You can see that in business.
Yes.
You just don't call people, individuals from the backyard and say, do this for me.
Well, you see the CEO, you see the secretary, you see the ambience.
Yeah.
And that gives you the confidence to transact business. But if you meet someone just under the tree and he tells you,
he's an agent,
I'm capable of clearing goods, and you also risk it and give your goods to him to clear for you, then it's a risk you are taking.
I see. So this gentleman took the risk, and today he has to fight it by himself.
Yes.
And it's possible he lost everything.
He will lose. Surely he will lose everything.
And there's a point. There's another section where he is saying that he showed documents, evidence that he paid the gentleman some amount of money, about 17,000, that he said, the agent said, it was going to be paid to customs in banker's draft with customs name on it.
Mm.
Yet
he got a receipt from customs that it says 15,000. The remaining 2,000, he doesn't know where it has gone. Is this possible?
You see, when you go to the bank and pay money, they generate a receipt for you that covers the amount of duty paid.
Yes.
So if it is 15,000, it will reflect 15,000. If 15,000 is now ready in 17,000, then after he had a receipt for the 15,000, he may have gone to, you know, generate another document. I don't know how the person made it, but 15,000 cedis in the system will reflect 16,000 on the document or the receipt.
No, he paid 17, almost over 16,000, yes.
That's right.
Close to 17,000.
That's right.
In the name of customs.
That's right.
Yet he got a receipt from his clearing agent of 15,000 from customs.
That's not possible, no. Never possible. We are using a computer platform for the processing of our documentations. If you go to the bank and pay, whatever you pay at the bank reflects on the customs declaration. It also reflects on the receipt that is generated by the banks. So there will be no, but it's not possible for you to pay 17,000 cedis and to reflect as 15,000 cedis or the other way around.
Because that's what it shows, that he gives, the gentleman came asking for 17,000.
Yes.
That this is what customs is asking
that's
for.
That's right.
So he went to pay to the bank.
The guy went to pay. Who went to pay?
The importer went to pay. Give him the 17,000 to go and pay together.
That's
with the
right. Clearing. I'm happy you said that. You said the importer gave the agent the money to go and pay.
So it's possible he didn't pay that amount.
No, it is. You know, it's a fact that he didn't pay.
He didn't pay the 17.
Yes.
I see.
It's not a possibility.
So he paid the 15,000. That's why he brought a receipt.
Yes, he may have entered the bank without him.
Yeah.
So he took the 17,000, entered the bank. Whatever happens at the bank is only known to the agent.
I see.
That's right.
How can importers avoid these things?
You have to be diligent. You have to be careful in your choice of customs house agents you use. You even have to engage customs officers in determining who should work for you. If you come to me and tell me you want an agent, I'll look around and get you a very good one. Once the agent even knows that I am the one who even assists in the choice of him,
He'll be careful,
you know. So,
and you have a list of accredited ones and well-certified agents.
We know them. Yes. The very good ones, we know them.
So why don't you get rid of the bad ones?
You see, those who
should get rid of. If you know the good ones.
There is a system that handles all this. If you are an agent and you are always caught engaging fraudulent acts, the system itself will block you from working.
Yeah.
You see?
Yeah.
So we have a way of handling all these things. But the risk is that people wouldn't listen.
They will still go for the individuals.
That's why we even tell them that when you are buying a vehicle from somebody, before you even effect payments, come to customs and verify the authenticity of the vehicle documents you have been given. But ask yourself, how many people do that?
Yeah.
Even yesterday, someone came to me with a document, you know, for a vehicle he has paid for, and it turned out to be a fake document. But what is it? He has already paid in full. So, it ends there.
Well, so to customs, this is not surprising. They get some of these things all the time. That's why, folks, you are being advised always that deal with the right agencies that clear goods out of the port. Please, do not be fooled by any individual just because somebody has told you they know them to be clearing agents or anybody else. They can just throw their numbers away and dupe you, take your money somewhere. So please be diligent and ensure that nobody makes a fool out of you. Well, next week we will be picking another aspect of this particular story, and I should remind you that we'll also be updating you on the Honda CRV story, because people, there is good news for the gentleman called Andy who reported to us that he brought his car from the US of A to Ghana, and less than 2 months, actually less than 60 days of the car's arrival, unfortunately for him, the customs have allocated that car to somebody else. Indeed, it's an unfortunate incident, and we will be bringing you update. But I can assure you that Andy will be smiling in our next episode of Iron Pod. We'll return after the break.
Hello.
Good morning. This is Samantha Wendy's. I am sending a purchase order from SAT Ventures International.
Lovely.
For pineapples.
For how many containers?
Our policy for new supplies is 2 containers to start with, but you must deliver within 30 days.
Don't worry at all. I'm going to get you the 4 containers within 30 days or less.
Congratulations, Mr. Appiah.
You have just secured your first order from SA2 Ventures International. Time to process the paperwork. Do you remember you have exactly 30 days to deliver? To get his pineapple slices from his country to his clients overseas, Mr. Appiah and his representatives have to complete a number of regulatory compliance procedures to various international trade stakeholders. For instance, he has to obtain financial documents such as letters of credit, payment receipts and invoices, complete regulatory documents such as declarations, make permit applications, obtain food hygiene certificates, complete transportation documentations such as manifest, bill of lading, and manage port requirements. Going round and round in circles and up and down from office to office, doing the same paperwork over and over again. Stop! Does it really have to be this way? In a single window environment, Mr. Appiah can complete processes for his sales invoice, manifest, declarations, permits, certificates, letters of credit, payment receipts, licenses, and all other international trade supply chain processes. Assessing all agencies and stakeholders in one place 24/7. Let's see what happens when Mr. Appiah trades in a single window environment. Using single window, Mr. Appiah has completed all his international trade procedures through one portal. He has registered his company information, applied for the necessary permit, certificates and licenses, and all that remains is for him to get a text alert for clearance and movement of goods.
Hello, good morning. You just ordered 2 container pineapple slices. I was wondering, can I supply you the shoes as well?
And that's how simple facilitating international trade could be in a single window environment. You can offer competitive services to your trading partners in China, America, England, India, and yes, even here, in a simpler, faster, and cost-effective way. Single window, the only way to Ghana's economic growth, is in our hands.
When cleaning your vehicle by valeting, steaming, waxing, or polishing, make sure the engine is also sound. Servicing your vehicle with gold synthetic oil and any quality Goil oil massages the engine, removes deposit, protects it from wear and tear for longer lasting performance, and makes your vehicle fuel pumped. Made for diesel and super engines. Remember, after every 15,000 kilometers of enjoying your ride, service your engine with Goil synthetic oil.
We are a champion. That's why I, Azuma Nelson, 3-time world boxing champion and a patriot, always choose Goil.
Ashine Pankasa. Goil, good energy.
For all ship repairs and maintenance work, count on the Takoradi Shipyard. Takoradi Shipyard, efficiency, reliability, and perfection.
Coming up next, news and activities happening in and around the ports and maritime industry, including the first meeting of the Director General of Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority, as well as managers of the Ports and Harbors Authority with the staff of the Tema Shipyard. That's the first meeting since the takeover of that facility by GPHA.
Onyame som som sabro sa be your The Director General of the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority, Richard Anamo, has assured staff of the Tema Shipyard of a brighter future if only the workers will put in all their expertise and work hard to ensure that the once productive shipyard is brought back to life. Speaking at his first interaction with the workers and management of the Tema Shipyard and flanked by some management team of GPHA, Richard Anamo, in an inspirational speech which attracted applause from the staff, charged workers of the Tata Tema Shipyard to assist in transforming the facility into a business enterprise.
We all should rise up to the challenge of national demand. That we should turn this company into a company that is worth it. That we can be proud of. That we can say, pay me this because we have it. Not pay me this irrespective of where the money is coming from.
He said with the right attitude from workers, the shipyard will attract the needed investment to make it vibrant. He charged the staff to shun any lackadaisical attitude towards work and demonstrate professionalism to duty.
The vessels can be outside there and some of you will leave the job here and go and begin one-to-one-to job offshore. Then we all know that some of us think that it's a place here that we might be taking our, doing our own private enterprise inside the yard. Then we all know. But that is not going to send us anywhere.
He warned against prohibited operational habits.
If you get drunk and we find you, we'll let you go and sit at the gate because that's a place for drinking people. Until the alcohol comes out, you are not allowed to come to the yard.
Richard Anamo assured that no worker will be laid off.
We are not here to lay off people. We are here to transform the institution.
He reminded the staff of the dilapidated state of the facility and the lack of funds.
Rise up to this occasion. That 3 months time, 6 months time, when we meet again, will not be pop our figures like this.
He also urged the workers to live in unity.
Let us shed away the issues of you belong to this party, I belong to this party, you belong to this religious group. When you enter that day, when you leave your house and you wear your dress or you get up and say you are going to work, the only thing that is in your mind is Tema Shipyard, nothing else.
The workers expressed optimism and pledged their unflinching support to the GPHA and the new management.
Allies, the spirit of Kwame Nkrumah in the Director General. Director General, I can assure you, fear not, we will deliver for you. We always need someone with vision so that we can go with it. And we thank God that God has brought you to us.
The Minister of Trade and Industry, Dr. Ecos Biogabra, together with the Minister of Transport, Fifi Kwete, have promised transit truck drivers who are stuck at the transit terminal that the challenge of delays will be addressed in no time. In the past few weeks, some transit drivers have been stranded at the transit terminal due to inadequate tracking devices. The tracking devices are meant to check instances where goods meant for transit are diverted. According to the two ministers who paid a working visit to the transit terminal to assess the level of trade and challenges at the terminal, government is putting in place measures to make Ghana the preferred point of all businesses as far as the maritime transit business is concerned. This, the transport minister said, will make many more people want to use the country's corridor to facilitate trade.
We will quickly move into action to make sure that the issues are addressed as quickly as possible in order to ensure that there is a quick flow of traffic from here. And so that you don't spend so many days, waiting for the system to clear you in order for you to be on the move. Because there's a lot of money that's being wasted. And so that's a lot of, a discouraging situation for all of you and, of course, for the country as a whole.
Ghana wants to be the center of ECOWAS trade and investment. And we cannot succeed in doing so if we are unable to make this terminal efficient enough for 150 to 200 vehicles every single day to come in and get out. There are companies that have been contracted to do some of this work who we have to ensure that they do their work properly.
As a port authority, we perform by the throughput per hour per square meter. So when vehicles or cargo is standing at one point, the port is not performing. and therefore, I mean, their presence here is reassuring.
The leadership of the trackers urged their members to remain calm and wait for the authorities to resolve the situation. A delegation from the Nigerian Export Promotion Council have engaged in a cross-border collaboration with a West Blue consultant, Ghana Revenue Authority, GRA, and the Ghana Export Promotion Authority as part of the Ghana National Single Window Program. At the deliberation, which was facilitated by West Blue consultant, the Nigerian delegation and their Ghanaian counterparts discussed issues on key border processes and product challenges and opportunities. They also discussed ways to reduce illicit trade between Ghana and Nigeria by the sharing of timely data information. Executive Director of the Nigerian Export Promotion Council lauded the Ghana National Single Window Program, stressing that it will have far-reaching benefits for the country. He complained about the weakness in inter-Africa trade, which he said accounts for 4% of global trade.
Everything Africa needs is in Africa. But if we are not, you know, integrating and trading amongst ourselves, we risk to really perish our continent.
The Commissioner General of the Ghana Revenue Authority, George Blankson, emphasized the need for developing economies to place prominence on export rather than import.
When it comes to trade facilitation, the facilitation shouldn't be seen only in the context of imports. How do we facilitate imports? You must also consider, and even perhaps more importantly, how do we facilitate exports?
The Chief Executive Officer of West Blue Consulting, Valentina Minta, said deepening collaboration between Ghana and Nigeria will achieve a common goal of trade facilitation using the National Single Window.
We don't want to create the best Rolls Royce of a single window in Ghana, the best Rolls Royce of a single window in Nigeria, but then we can use each other's roads. It becomes very, you don't achieve the ultimate vision and objective.
The delegation visited the Ghana Export Promotion Authority to exchange further ideas. The Tema Chamber of Commerce has organized its media business meeting under the theme Planning and Negotiating Financial Deals. The meeting afforded members the opportunity to exchange ideas with regards to how to sharpen their negotiation skills in order to make best deals out of them. Participants were challenged on their achievements over the first half of the year, their setbacks, missed or explored opportunities, problem-solving skills, and projections for the second half.
Finance has become very important and a constraint on development of a lot of the SMEs. So they should be able to think long-term over the life of their businesses and see the phases of development of their businesses from the conception stage to the startup stage to growth stage to maturity stage and even to decline as to how they are going to finance.
Professor Heto also guided participants through business matchmaking opportunities, loan acquisition proposals and other trade-related programs. The oil marketing industry has become very competitive and dynamic, and as a result, Ghana Oil, also known as GOIL, which is the leading indigenous oil marketing company in the country, has embarked on a campaign to demonstrate to motorists and the general public the efficacy of its lubricants oil. GOIL is currently making great strides in the bunkering industry with the construction of marine gas oil tanks in Ghana's port. GOIL is also supplying a number of airlines with quality aviation fuel and currently gaining recognition for providing the best aviation fuel on the continent. Additionally, GOIL is strategically embarking on a roadshow across the country to create awareness about its lubricants in order to maintain its lead in the supply of lubricants within the industry. The lubricants marketing manager of GOIL, who led the campaign, said motorists and the general public stand to gain immensely from patronizing GOIL products because they are of high quality, they ensure high engine performance and very affordable.
As a company, we have every kind of lubricant that they require to use for their vehicles and machinery. And then secondly, is to get our products to every corner that lubricants are sold in the country. It's not only Accra. I thought we'll be replicating in all the other zones. That GOIL, we have it. Quality and affordable price.
The campaign was also used to register new GOIL customers who would want to retail GOIL products. Joshua Kwabna Dioju assured customers of GOIL of value for money anytime they buy their products from GOIL retail outlets.
Hello.
Good morning. This is Samantha Wendy's.
I am sending a purchase order from SAT Ventures International.
Lovely.
For pineapples.
For how many containers?
Our policy for new supplies is 2 containers to start with, but you must deliver within 30 days.
Don't worry at all. I'm going to get you the 4 containers within 30 days or less.
Congratulations, Mr. Apia. You have just secured your first order from SA2 Ventures International. Time to process the paperwork. Do you remember you have exactly 30 days to deliver? To get his pineapple slices from his country to his clients overseas, Mr. Apia and his representatives have to complete a number of regulatory compliance procedures to various international trade stakeholders. For instance, he has to obtain financial documents such as letters of credit, payment receipts and invoices, complete regulatory documents such as declarations, make permit applications, obtain food hygiene certificates, complete transportation documentations such as manifest, bill of lading, and manage port requirements. Going round and round in circles and up and down from office to office, doing the same paperwork over and over again. Stop! Does it really have to be this way? In a single window environment, Mr. Apia can complete processes for his sales invoice, manifest, declarations, permits, certificates, letters of credit, payment receipts, licenses, and all other international trade supply chain processes. Assessing all agencies and stakeholders in one place 24/7. Let's see what happens when Mr. Apia trades in a single window environment. Using single window, Mr. Apia has completed all his international trade procedures through one portal. He has registered his company information, applied for the necessary permit, certificates and licenses, and all that remains is for him to get a text alert for clearance and movement of goods. And that's how simple facilitating international trade could be in a single window environment. You can offer competitive services to your trading partners in China, America, England, India, and yes, even here, in a simpler, faster, and cost-effective way. Single window, the only way to Ghana's economic growth, is in our hands.
For all ship repairs and maintenance work, count on the Takoradi Shipyard. Takoradi Shipyard, efficiency, reliability, and perfection.
When cleaning your vehicle by valeting, steaming, waxing, or polishing, make sure the engine is also sound. Servicing your vehicle with Gold Synthetic Oil and any quality Goil oil massages the engine, removes deposit, protects it from wear and tear for longer lasting performance, and makes your vehicle fuel pumped. Made for diesel and super engines. Remember, after every 15,000 kilometers of enjoying your ride, service your engine with Goil Synthetic Oil.
We are a champion. That's why I, Azuma Nelson, 3-time world boxing champion and a patriot, always choose Goil.
Ashine Pankasa. Goil, good energy.
Schedules of vessels in the ports, those at Anchorage and those expected for the coming week, plus the Bank of Ghana exchange rate next. Next week, we will be getting a lot of advice as far as how we can handle the clearing agencies, the customs house agencies in doing business in the port, from the outgone port security manager, Colonel Timothy Batabana, who under his watch arrested a few of some of those situations. That's it for this episode of Eye on Port. And I have to thank you for watching the program. Also, thanks to the crew, Robert Nyantechi, Godwin Kabute, Solomon Anderson, Joe Lavo, also Fia Joe Nelson, that wonderful young man who has just joined the team, very calm guy and hardworking as well. We say thank you for coming on board. And the executive producers, Paul Asariansa and Abna Sewa Opokufusu. Thank you.